he went with Dr. Bob Jones to Europe in the middle 30s, before the Second World War. Now, I'm named after Bob Jones. And Bob Jones did the wedding ceremony for my mother and father. And I think I'm Bob Jones's biggest disappointment in life. Because going through Bob Jones, you were supposed to be a good, reliable Christian fundamentalist, and a terrorist would be all right. But my father went with the idea that they could convert the Jews of Europe to be Christians and save them from the fascists and the Nazis. So I asked my father, I said, well, isn't that kind of like converting the Jews at the point of a sword? He said, yes, well, that's been done through centuries, you know? And so we thought we could convert the Jews to be Christians and it would save them from the Nazis. So I said, did you convert any Jews? And he said, no, but they converted me. So here he is, a Klansman from Birmingham, Alabama, in the middle of Europe, on the brink of the most horrendous Holocaust and genocide in history, and he goes identifying with the Nazis and fascists, his ideological brothers, and then he begins to work with the Jewish underground, and so he has to dodge the Gestapo, and he's in Germany, he's in Poland, Latvia, Estonia, and parts of the Soviet Union, so he has to dodge the KGB, the Gestapo, and so forth, on these little rounds. And he begins to identify with the persecuted, not the persecutor. And begins to change him in his logic. And I said, well, Dad, something happened, though, in your heart. What happened to you, personally, in your heart? He said, well, the main thing I remember was that I had been in Russia for 8 months in the dead of winter, hearing no native English spoken, just my translator, my driver, who was traveling by horse-drawn sled in deep snow. And he said, I was thinking about home, homesick as I could be. And our little group joined up with a group of gospel singers who were on the same little church circuit, underground church circuit, evangelical church circuit. They were gospel singers from the South, and they were all African Americans. So my dad said he was just joy-stricken because they could talk about cornbread and sliced tomatoes and okra, you know. And all of the hot biscuits and ham and grits and gravy, you know. And he said this, we sang the same songs, we prayed the same prayers. And he said, I thought I was having a nervous breakdown because I forgot they were black. And he said, I kept reminding myself, this is important, it's been important your whole life. They're black, you're white. He said, but the more we stayed together, the more I forgot. And he said, I realized that all the people in Europe called us the Americans. And they didn't make any distinction between the black Americans or the white Americans. We were the Americans. And he said, I decided to make it easy on myself and forget about black and white until I got back to Birmingham and then I'd be a good Klansman again. But he said, Bob, that ruined me as a Klansman. I was ruined as a Klansman. Because they took that leaf from the movement, grassroots organizing. So what I would say to do with Brother Brownback is to organize, organize, organize. And that is to bring together coalitions. What we're doing in North Carolina is we've gotten together because it's a swing state and Obama carried it. He needs to carry it again as well as Virginia. We have 120 nonprofits, churches, all kinds of organizations, especially young people. And 3 weeks ago, we had 12 to 15,000 people marching on the now controlled Republican legislature in Raleigh. So we have a tremendous movement going on there. That's where we're going to have Freedom Summer this summer, with young people coming from all over. You can do the similar thing here, I think, and take a page from the Tea Party. Say, I'm going to dedicate myself to working to change the school board. What they did in a lot of cases was started with the school boards, the county boards and so forth. They didn't start with the bigger offices. They organized, they won those things, and then they parlayed it into a groundswell. In an off-presidential year, just 2 years ago, or whatever it was, the last election. And they made a tremendous sweep. One of the things they're doing us a favor on is they're overstepping any kind of mandate that they may have gotten. Just about everywhere, like Wisconsin, when that governor got in by a narrow margin, he moved to take a collective bargaining away from people in Wisconsin, where it was actually invented. Wisconsin and Michigan and so forth, with the sit-in strikes in organized labor, and they stirred up a hornet's nest. So stir up the hornet's nest here in Kansas. Get people together, find out who's working on it together. Get a coalition together. If you want to, I'll come back and speak to that group. We'll get Reverend Barber, who is organizing in North Carolina, to come here to Kansas. Let's do it in every state where we're going to have to push back, because we can't sit around anymore. They have out-organized us, out-fundraised us, and they have, luckily, they've overstepped their mandate. So it's time now to swing it back the other way. So that's what I would say. I would say I don't know that much about all the issues, but I know that Kansas has a grand heritage of fighting against slavery. It was a free state, and they fought to keep it a free state. So that heritage is here, that progressive heritage is here, and I don't think it's a mean state. I don't think that most of the people here are mean. And if you challenge them on the basis of love and getting along together, and let that other guy go try to find common ground with Mr. Brownback, that's fine. Those people where the president kept reaching over, they absolutely turned him down on everything except those things they were forced to vote on, the couple of bills just recently. They really had to support those. They could not do away with the income, the income tax for working people. They didn't want to do that, so that was common ground anyway. They even got to the point where proposals that they had originally initiated that were adopted by President Obama, if he adopted them, they turned against them. So they didn't care anything about jobs or the worth of our country. They only wanted to take it as far over to the extreme as they possibly could, and they have done so. So it's a good organizing opportunity for us.